So, as I mentioned last time, this is the end of a very difficult segment, leading into the beginning of another very difficult segment, probably the hardest in the whole game, because I'm about to face the Omega Pirate, which is usually considered the hardest boss in the game with full, like, inventory. So, you can imagine that doing it under these conditions is in no way fun. Especially when you get heap shots like that. But, yeah, I'm not expecting to beat it in this segment. This is going to be a segment, like, full of failures, just to show how god-awful this boss fight really is. So you go up to it. Luckily, you can cancel it a little bit earlier and get some cheap shots in on him. Not very many, though. Okay, here's the deal with this fight. This guy is basically just a glorified elite pirate, which weren't that hard to take down. He takes a lot longer, but he's not that much harder. Except for the fact that he summons minions. That's where it gets hard, because he just sends out the different pirates with that are weak to the different weapons, which are hard by themselves usually. Not to mention that there will be two of them, usually of different colors. And you've got to worry about this guy at the same time, because he's going to be reappearing, and you have to damage him quickly before his, like, phase of being able to be damaged is over. So, basically, you just got to take out all his armor with the plasma beam, which takes, like, a week. Yeah, and there's Phazon laying around, too. You got to kind of be aware of where that is so you don't keep stepping in it. Great, I ran into him. So yeah, he comes over here, the first phase is, he'll always send out two of the same. I can maybe kill one of these, because I gotta be ready to attack whenever he appears. And there's like a sound effect to cue that. And these guys aren't shooting, because sometimes they just don't. Okay, there he is, so here's how you damage him. You gotta lay a power bomb and quickly turn on the X-ray visor. That is the only way to damage him, aside from using, like, regular missiles, which aren't gonna do jack shit against this guy. Unless I have, like, a million of them. So, wait, where is he? Oh, crap. Yeah, I can't hit him again. So, yeah, that's basically the fight in a nutshell. Take out the armor. Kill the little guys if you can. Jesus, how did I miss that jump? Then hit them with a power bomb and repeat. And it gets worse because, like I said, that first wave, the two guys are always going to be the same color. After that, they stop being the same color. Maybe the second one too, but eventually they're going to stop being the same color, so you got to usually deal with two different ones. You gotta hope for plasma beam ones, because they die the quickest. And also, it's like they'll randomly either be shooters or slashers. Obviously, slashers are better, because they're not going to be hitting you from afar. You can keep your distance on them. And I keep stepping in the goddamn Phazon. So yeah, at this point, I'm kind of boned. I've only got 24 energy here. I gotta hope for slasher plasma beam guys to show up, because they're going to be the easiest to take out. So I can at least kill one of them and get some energy from it. And that's really all I've got to say about this. It's going to be hell. And we've got a wave beam, guys. My favorite. But it doesn't look like they're shooting me. So that's one good thing. Come on, and it keeps breaking my lock-on for some reason. Oh, God, I just ran into it. Come on, die. I can't go... Okay, Ultra Energy, where is he? Where is he? Where the hell is he? Okay, got some damage on him. But yeah, as I've said before, and I probably just said it like 3 minutes ago on it, but I wasn't paying attention. This guy will only take damage if you're using the X-ray visor, so that's why that item is required. So you gotta lay the power bomb and immediately switch to that thing. And I must say, I am doing phenomenally well at this. Like, I was sucking, but then I got those ultra energies. If I actually manage to beat this, I am going to be, like, flabbergasted. Because this guy usually takes me hours. I've lost against this guy in a 100% run. Like, I don't know how, but I just did. It was on hard mode, but that's not that much worse. So, I don't know, like, I've got nothing to say, really. At this point, I'm just rambling, but I gotta kind of focus on the fight. I can't be talking about too much. Okay, now they're gonna be different colors, I can almost assure you of that. So, what do we got? Ice. Oh, two ice. And, I think at least one of them is a shooter. Oh god, there's three of them? I don't remember him ever having three. I can at least kill this guy to get some energy out in there, but, like, not that I really need to pick it up yet, but, oh god, he's back. I might be able to kill him, actually. Hold on. Come on, come on, come on. Is he dead? Oh my god. How the fuck did I do that? This is recording, right? Holy shit. I've got nothing to say here. Yeah, and it shows the gravity suit instead of the phazon suit because it's, like, all screwed up. But, oh my god. That was the luckiest damn thing ever. I hope I can get back to the save station because I'm, like, too stunned to do anything. Oh, man. I don't think I'll ever be able to top that in anything that I ever upload ever again. Unless I do the same thing for the final boss as well. But, Jesus Christ. Okay, I think I'm over the initial shock of that, but, like, oh man. And I think I have enough time to get that on artifact, too. I gotta go back for that. Oh, man. Where is that room, anyway? Is it just behind this one? I don't want to have to go through too much crap. It looks like all the pirates have been replaced by Metroids, which is a very welcome change, because the Metroids are easier to kill. Yeah, wait. Oh, crap, yeah, I got a mushroom room to go through. That sucks. But whatever, I can stand in the phazon now, and I'm not terrified of dying because I just saved, so I'm just gonna sort of run through it. Alright, so yeah, you just sort of go through here. You can get through this without the phazon suit, but you need at least 13 energy tanks to do so. Which is all but one of them, and you get one of the energy tanks right after beating the Omega Pirate anyway. So, like, for a 23%, it's obviously not going to happen. The only other way to do it is in a 100% run where you get everything before this. Oh, and I guess I never really mentioned, this brings me up to 22%. 23 being that last artifact, which is just in the temple, which you can get from the very start of the game, but I didn't. The phazon suit does not count towards your percentage, because it's kind of glitchy, actually. Like, the phazon suit plus beam item, it doesn't count, because it's given to you in a cutscene and you never pick it up. The game only will recognize it after you get all the other items in the game. So if you're only missing one item, it's going to say that you have 98%. But then, like, after you get that last item, then it's going to kick you up to 100 without ever going to 99. And holy crap, these things are ganging up on me. And also, if you haven't been able to see it, the morph ball is the regular Variasuit color here because I don't have the spider ball. And a Phazon suit color morph ball without the spider ball was never created. Like a model for it. It was never made because it's not supposed to be possible. So it just sort of shows the regular Variasuit morph ball. And I'm not going to have enough time to get to the save room probably, but you're not missing much. Ah, shit. Yeah, whatever. Just assume that I get to the save room safe and sound, because there's not much else to do here. But, yeah, that was a pretty badass segment, I've got to admit. So, see you next time.